so epic. Hello, everybody. Happy Thursday. My name is Josh Wilson, and I am so excited to be a part of this evening's Hope on Demand live stream concert. I'm coming to you from my home studio in Nashville, Tennessee, and I know you could be watching from anywhere, and maybe you're watching an archived file of this video. We're airing it live on Thursday, but maybe you're watching it on a Friday or a Monday. Who knows where you are? Maybe you're in Tennessee, maybe you're in Texas, maybe you're in Germany. I don't know. Wherever you're watching from, welcome. I am so glad to have you here, and we are going to have a great time tonight. Thank you so much to Hope on Demand for hosting this evening. I'm going to start with a song that talks about who I used to be and who I am now, and it's called That Was Then, This Is Now. We used to hide from the light. We made friends with the night. We were headed the wrong way on a one-way track, going nowhere fast. We got used to the dark. We thought, this is who we are. And we figured that we were just too far gone. But we were wrong. Cause love came running like a river. We got washed in the water. Then he said, you forget it. Your sins are gone. That was then. This is now. You're bought by the blood, saved by the sun. The saints all sing about. That was lost. This is found. It's time to say goodbye to the old you now. Go ahead, put the past in the past. Box it up like an old photograph. You don't have to go back, cause that was then. And this is now. We've been remade by grace. We've all got new names. And nothing we do could ever change what he did that day. When love came running like a river, we got lost in the water. Then he said, you forget it. And you belong. That was then. This is now. Saved by the sun, the saints all sing about. That was lost, this is found. It's time to say goodbye to the old you now. Go ahead, put the past in the past. Box it up like an old photograph. You don't have to go back, cause that was then. If we turn and confess every unrighteousness, he is faithful and just to forgive. So turn and confess every wrong and regret, and see what it means to live. That was then, this is now. Bought by the blood, saved by the sun, the saints all sing about. That was lost, this is found. It's time to say goodbye to the old you now. Go ahead, put the past in the past. Box it up like an old photograph. You don't have to go back, cause that was then. Go ahead, put the past in the past. Box it up like an old photograph. You don't have to go back, cause that was then. This is now. This is now. All right, so that song was called That Was Then, and This Is Now. And right now, I'm so thrilled to be with you on this Hope on Demand live stream. Also want to say thanks to tonight's sponsor, Food for the Hungry. You're going to hear a little bit more about them later. We are so appreciative that they have sponsored this evening and made it possible for us to spend this time together. And what a crazy time it is, right? A lot of us have been quarantined in our homes. We're keeping a little chart upstairs about how long we've been here. And I think here in the Wilson household, it's been 8 weeks that we have been vigilantly quarantining here in our house. And so I'm thankful for opportunities like this for us to get together and spend some time of encouragement. And, you know, I'm going to share these songs and some stories behind the songs. And I also want to say thank you so much to those who are on the front lines fighting this pandemic, those who are in healthcare, doctors, nurses, those who are essential workers who this whole time have been going to work, you who work in grocery stores and convenience stores and drivers and, you know, mail workers and all of you folks who have continued to do your essential work. Thank you for the work that you're doing. I actually want to dedicate this next song to those essential workers. And this evening, I want to introduce my band to you. I always do this live. My band actually consists of me, myself, and I, which means we'll be doing some live looping. Okay, so down here on the floor, I've got these loop pedals, and you can see this one on the left here. This is the looper. This is my effects pedal here, and then my tuner over there. And the way this thing works is you can step on this red pedal right here while you're playing your guitar. And it records what you're playing, and then it starts to loop it back, and you can sort of add layers as you go. So the band is me, myself, and I, which means on the guitar, we have me. Here we go. On the kick drum, we have myself. And on the shaker tonight, we have the most unruly member of my band, I. And I truly believe we all have a light to shine, the light and life that Jesus gives us. We are to shine into this dark world. And so no matter where you find yourself, you have a part to play. You have a light to shine. And that's what this song is all about.
1 million reasons why shouldn't even try. After all, you're just one heart, single candle in the dark. There are shadows here feeding on your fears that you don't have what it takes. Who are you to make a change? But oh, 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 don't underestimate the God you follow. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Somebody needs the light you have. Whatever you do, just don't lose heart. Keep on pushing back the door. Keep on pushing back the door. The city on a hill, it should be shining still. Every sinner saved by grace has a purpose, has a place inside the bigger plan we might not understand. So if we just keep walking on, we're gonna see the kingdom come. Yeah. Whatever you do, just don't look back. Somebody leaves the light you have. Whatever you do, just don't lose heart. Keep on pushing back the door. Keep on pushing back the door.
All right, I'm gonna ask you to do something that might seem a little bit strange because we're watching on live stream. But I have a part I want you to sing, and no matter where you're watching from, I want you to sing it out, okay? If you're watching on your TV, on your phone, on your computer, if you're sitting at home, if you're sitting in your parked car, wherever you are watching this, I want you to sing this. Here we go.
Let your light so shine.
Sing it out.
Let your light so shine.
You got a light to shine, sing it out.
Let your light so shine.
Just you, come on.
Let your light so shine.
Here we go.
Let your light so shine.
When you feel like you're too small,
let your light so shine to do any good at all. And let your light so shine like a sunrise through the window. Let your light so shine like a symphony crescendo. We are waking up again. We are rising from the dead. We're shining like the stars. We are pushing back the
let your light so shine.
One more.
Let your light so shine. Would you dare to believe that you still have a reason to sing? Cause the pain that you've been feeling can't compare to the joy that's coming. Hold on, you gotta wait for the light. Press on and just fight the good fight. Cause the pain that you've been feeling, it's just the dark before the morning. My friend, you know how this all ends. You know where you're going. You just don't know how you'll get there. So say a prayer and hold on. There's good for those who love God. But life is not a snapshot. It might take a little time, but you'll see the bigger picture. Would you dare to believe that you still have a reason to sing? Cause the pain that you've been feeling can't compare to the joy that's coming. Hold on, you gotta wait for the light. Press on and just fight. Fight, cause the pain that you've been feeling, it's just the dark before the morning. Once you feel the weight of glory, all your pain will fade to memory. Once you feel the weight of glory, all your pain will fade to memory, 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 yeah. Would you dare to believe that you still have a reason to sing? Cause the pain that you've been feeling can't compare to the joy that's coming. Come on, you gotta wait for the light. Press on and just fight the good fight. Cause the pain that you've been feeling, it's just the hurt before the healing. Oh, the pain that you've been feeling, it's just the dark before the morning.
Okay, so we sent out on social media, we asked if some of you might have had some questions and want to answer some questions. Somebody asked how I got my start in music, and I actually have loved music for as long as I can remember. I'm originally from Lubbock, Texas. Now, if you've never been to Lubbock, Texas, let me give you a picture of what it's like. It's very flat. There are no hills. It's very dry. Prominent color there, you know, on trees and grass is brown. There's not a lot of rain there. And it's, speaking of trees, there aren't many trees. So there's nothing to get in your view of the horizon. My granddad, who still lives in Lubbock, Texas, he actually says, you can see your dog running away from you for 3 days. So that kind of gives you an image of where I grew up. But I actually started piano lessons in the fourth grade. And then I started guitar and drums in the sixth and the seventh grade. And those are my three primary instruments. Piano was my first, but guitar, I'd say, is the one I use the most. And that's sort of how I got my start in playing instruments. And then I got really interested in songwriting when I was in college. I love how a song can speak to a part of us that words can't. Sometimes that even pictures can't. Only music can get to those places, at least in my heart. And I wanted to learn how to do that. So while I was in college, I studied the craft of songwriting and started writing songs of my own and have been doing so ever since. I went to college here in Nashville, Tennessee. I went to Belmont University. And there was what they call the Christian Music Showcase. And I actually entered that Christian Music Showcase, and from that got introduced to some folks here in Nashville in the music industry, and I spent a decade at Capitol Records under Sparrow Records, and now I am signed to Black River Records and have been putting out music with them for a couple years now. So that's how I got my start, and that's how I got to where I am now. And I am so thankful. I'm also just realizing I have this chapstick that's in the shot. I'm going to hide that from your view. I don't want anybody to think my lips are chapped. So that's how I got my start, and I am so thankful and so blessed to be able to travel the country now, and even the world, playing my music. And in fact, the next song I want to play for you, I wrote when I was in Mumbai, India, and it's a song called Shine on Us, and I want to use the loop pedal for this one. And yeah, if you know it, you can sing along wherever you are. Don't be shy. Nobody's going to hear you. Unless, I guess, you're in a room with, you know, a family member or something. But that's okay. Just pretend you're in the shower and nobody's listening. This song's called Shine on Us. It goes like this. Doesn't sleep at night. At 10 o'clock it comes alive. There's 20 million people, then there's me. A taxi driver every day. A lot of work, a little pay. Just looking for a way to find some peace. But finding peace is way too hard when you're looking in the dark. So shine, shine, shine on us. Your love. These streets aren't bright enough. Oh, Jesus, shine on us. Well, I'm sitting on this corner here. My dignity just disappears with every coin I beg into this cup. No matter how much people pay, it doesn't matter anyway. It never ever seems to be enough. So shine, shine, shine on us. Oh God, we need your love. These streets aren't bright enough. Oh Jesus, shine on us. Oh God above is full of mercy, turning darkness into dawn. All you who are weak and weary, lift your head, sing this song. Shine, shine, shine on us. Oh God, we need your love. These streets aren't bright enough. Oh Jesus, shine on us. Now, somebody else asked about my family, and my family I grew up in, my parents still live in Lubbock, Texas, where I grew up, and my dad's a pastor, and I'm actually married. My wife and I have been married for 10 years. We just celebrated 10 years of marriage. Her name's Becca, and she is from Oklahoma. She's from Tulsa. And we have a little boy named Asher, and he is 4 years old. And in related news, we've not slept in about 4 years. We really love our little boy, and I'm so thankful. You know, during this time of quarantine, one blessing for us has been that we get to spend a lot of extra time with Asher. So we are definitely not taking that for granted. We're soaking that up. And I want to play you a song that was actually inspired by Becca and Asher, because this song is about the little things. I truly believe the little things matter. Not only do they matter, but they matter just as much as the big things. If you've ever seen an orchestra on stage, you know that each person is just holding one instrument, and they just play their part. They play their one piece of music. But what happens as everyone is playing their one instrument and everyone plays in time together, it turns into this big, beautiful symphony, this big sound that would not exist without those individual pieces. Now, the Bible talks about it like this. It says we are all parts of the same body. We all have a different part to play. And so I believe every part matters. So that means you have a part to play. That means you know people I don't know. You have skills I don't have. You have relationships and opportunities I never will. And only you can do your part. Only you can play your part. And so as I play this song, I want you to remember that the little things matter, that with God's great love, they add up to be really big things anyway, if we're all playing our part, okay? So yes, we should dream big, but along the way, let's dare to dream small.
It's a mama singing songs about the Lord. It's a daddy spending family time the world says he cannot afford. These simple moments change the world. It's a pastor at a tiny little church. 40 years of loving on the broken and the hurt. These simple moments change the world. So James Small, don't buy the lie that you gotta do it all. Just let Jesus use you where you are. One day at a time, live well. Loving God and others as yourself. Find little ways where only you can help. With His great love, a tiny rock can make a giant fall. Dream small. It's visiting the widow down the street, or dancing on a Friday with your friend with special needs. These simple moments change the world. Of course, there's nothing wrong with bigger dreams. Just don't miss the minutes on your way to bigger things. No. Cause these simple moments change the world. Dream small. Don't buy the lie that you gotta do it all. Just let Jesus use you where you are. One day at a time, live well. Loving God and others as yourself. Find little ways where only you can help. With His great love, a tiny rock can make a giant fall. Dream small. Keep loving, keep serving, keep listening, keep learning, keep praying, keep hoping, keep seeking, keep searching. Out of the small things and watch them grow bigger. The God who does all things makes oceans from rivers. Small, don't buy the lie, but you gotta do it all. Just let Jesus use you where you are. One day at a time, live well. Loving God and others as yourself. Find little ways where only you can help. With His great love,
A tiny rock can make a giant fall. Five loaves and two fish can feed them all. When your dreams are small.
Don't forget, it is so important to dream small. All right. Someone else asked a question. They asked about my experience with anxiety. I know a lot of you out there might struggle with anxiety. I have for much of my life. When I was younger, it was... a good deal of social anxiety, which I still deal with sometimes. And as I've gotten older, some of my anxieties, a lot of times I can't really pinpoint the source. And there was a season in my life where my anxiety got so bad, I was having panic attacks. And there was about a 6-month period where I could barely leave my house because I kept having these panic attacks. And this journey in and through with anxiety and sometimes depression, which is its close cousin, it's not been an easy one. I used to think that if I'm a Christian, I'm supposed to sort of have it all together and not deal with this kind of thing. But the longer I follow Jesus, the more I realize I don't call myself a Christian because I have it all together. I actually call myself a Christian because I don't have it all together, because I need a Savior, because I need someone to hold me together when I'm falling apart. Jesus actually said, in this world, you will have troubles. So he promised us we're going to have trouble, even if we follow him. But I love what he said after that. He said, but take heart, for I have overcome this world. And I love what he says in Matthew. He says, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. And a thing that, for me, that a lot of times comes with anxiety is insomnia. And so when I can't sleep, man, that's exactly what I need. I need rest. And I'm so encouraged by the fact that even when I can't sleep, I can still rest in Jesus. The song's called Rest. The world spins in circles. I can't slow it down. My fears and my worries, they're screaming so loud. Just under the noise, there's a still small voice saying, rest, rest. Jesus is holding you. Rest, rest. There's nothing you have to do. Just lay down your burdens. God's got the world in his hands. So take a deep breath and rest. Just can't sleep. God, help me hear you as you sing over me. Just under the noise, with your still small voice, you're saying, rest, rest. Jesus
Jesus is holding you. Rest, rest. There's nothing you have to do. Just lay down your burdens, 'cause God's got the world in his hands. So take a deep breath and rest. Still my soul, you won't let me go. Still my soul, God, you don't let go. Rest, rest, Jesus is holding you. Rest, rest, there's nothing you have to do. Just lay down your burdens. See, God's got the world in his hands. So take a deep breath and rest. Just rest.
I hope we can all do that, rest in Jesus, even if we have anxiety or depression, even if we can't sleep. Jesus says, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Well, listen, I'm really excited because we are going to hear from our sponsor of the night. It's an incredible organization, incredible ministry, and an incredible opportunity. So let's hear from Food for the Hungry.
I think it's working, babe. Okay. Hey, everyone. My name's Eric Samuel Tim. I'm a pastor, artist, and author, Bible teacher, a Netflix subscriber. A lot of things happen in our living rooms. This amazing living room series, I hope you've been enjoying it. If you're just joining us, or if you're continuing to join us, or if this is the last one, whatever it is, it's amazing that we can take technology and from our living room here in Minnesota, my wife and I, she's my camera girl, to be able to connect with each other and those artists to be able to play their music and minister and give us a good dose of hope. A lot of amazing things happen in our living room. It's that gathering place for conversations and coffee and proximity. And right now we're really, like all of us, if you're like me, longing for that. I miss that human interaction that we had before this all happened. And there is a portion of scripture that I just want to share briefly with you. But in Genesis 2:18, God makes the earth and he says it's not good. It's not good for man to be alone. And my wife's nodding her head. And the truth is the world was just good until you got here, babe. And then it became very good. And I would just simply say very good can happen, and it's supposed to happen in our living rooms. We're not supposed to be face to camera and then camera to screen and then screen to face. We're supposed to be in the living room together. But did you know that despite all of that, we can still bring that very good, that proximity with each other that changes the world forever? My son Xander taught me this so important lesson from our living room. I'd love to just show you a little clip of what happened when Xander walked up to me and he says, Dad, I want to change the world. I want to sponsor a child. I need your credit card. That's exactly what he says. You remember, he said, I need your credit card. And so I made a decision in our living room to give my six-year-old that credit card, and you just got to see what happens. As this happened from our living room, I hope it blesses you and yours.
A credit card is something that you need to sponsor people.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. Xander, will you pray for Novellas for us?
Thank you, Jesus. Won't Novellas please help us to get food and shelter and water? Please, God, give Novellas free food. In Jesus' name, amen.
Isn't that amazing? Xander didn't know about the community development projects, didn't know about the church partnerships, didn't know about the places where Food for the Hungry works, where there is no church. He doesn't know about the graduation of communities until they're self-sustainable, which I love, by the way. It's not just handouts, it's literally hand-ups. It's not just giving people fish, it's teaching them how to fish, and that matters to me. He doesn't know all those things. All he knows is that his dad and his mom are in the living room and he has an opportunity to change the world, so he does it. Now is the time to do it. This pandemic that we have been in has caused us all to pause. But let me boldly remind you that this pandemic is just a part of our calendar, and poverty for so many people that are waiting to be rescued from it, to be equipped to get out of it, to be able to have the ability to change their future by the power of the gospel in front of it. That is not a pandemic. That is a way of life for that person. So change the world from your living room. If you've ever thought about sponsoring a child, sponsor a child today. If you already sponsor one, I'm gonna give you permission. You can sponsor another one. Make tonight your night, where you change the world from your living room. Sponsor a child for your kids like we do for ours, or your grandkids. And close in that gap of proximity. You and I are experiencing a microcosm of what it feels like to be isolated. Use the link, follow the directions to someone who is living. Just simply remind them that you have room for them. Thanks.
All right, welcome back. I have a brand new song I want to share with you. It's called Revolutionary, and this song is all about kindness. I believe as Christians, we, of course, the Bible says we are to be known by our love. And you probably remember those bracelets we used to wear a while ago, WWJD, maybe you still do. It's, what would Jesus do, of course, is the question those ask. And you might have seen the newer bracelets that say HWLF, He would love first. It's the answer to that question. And I love that pairing. What would Jesus do? He would love first. And I wrote this song knowing that 2020 was already going to be a crazy year. I knew, being an election year in the U.S., I knew things were going to get polarized and divided, and there's just, it seems like there's so much hate everywhere you look, whether it's the news or, you know, social media. Hate seems to be the default, the norm. And my vision for this song was, what if we could create a revolution of kindness? I think kindness stands out. Of course, Jesus was the ultimate revolutionary when it came to kindness. And I do my best to try and follow Jesus, and so I really believe that kindness matters. And so that's what this song is all about. It's called Revolutionary, and I hope you will join me in this kindness revolution. Truce, me and you can find a better way. Mistakes
sometime, open our eyes, look and listen. Yeah. We're gonna find we're more alike than we are different. Why does kindness seem revolutionary? When did we let it get so ordinary? Let's turn it around, flip the script, just slow love quick. God help us get revolutionary. Some common ground. See, maybe I'm not like you, but I walk a mile in your shoes. If it means I might see the world the way you do. Let's take some time, open our eyes, look and listen. We're gonna find we're more alike than we are different. Yeah. Why does kindness seem revolutionary? When did we let hate get so ordinary? Let's turn it around, flip the script, judge slow, love quick. God help us get revolutionary.
Love seeing all of the revolutionary acts of kindness that are happening during this pandemic. You know, there's so much bad news that we see in anywhere we look, but if you look hard enough, you'll find a bunch of good news. I love John Krasinski's YouTube show, Some Good News. Man, that is so encouraging, because amidst all the chaos, amidst all the fear and anxiety, there are some beautiful things happening. So let's start a revolution of kindness, and let's stand out in the right ways. All right, I got two more songs for you, and they're both instrumentals. I want to start with one of my favorite hymns. During these crazy times, I hope that this song can be maybe a balm for your soul. You know it. I didn't write it. This is just my arrangement of it. This is It Is Well With My Soul. Thank you. No matter what happens in this crazy world, it can still be well with our soul. I'm so thankful for that. Well, I just have one more song for you. And before I play it, I want to say thank you so much to Hope on Demand for hosting this evening. What an honor it has been to spend some time with you. And maybe it's not evening where you are. Maybe you're watching an archived file of this video, or you're in a different country where it's just not evening at all, even though we're airing this during a Thursday evening. Thank you to Hope on Demand for providing this opportunity. And also want to say thanks again to Food for the Hungry for sponsoring the night. What an incredible ministry, organization, and opportunity they give us. So thank you, Food for the Hungry. I'd love to keep up with you. I'm on all the social platforms, Instagram, Facebook, what else, Twitter, all that stuff. If you're on any of that, you can find my socials at my website, which is joshwilsonmusic.com. There's also some other fun stuff there. My store, my merchandise. I sell Dream Small Coffee, which is bags of coffee, ground coffee, that actually goes for an amazing cause. It builds water wells in Uganda, Africa, which is really fun, and it's delicious coffee. Also on my website, there's a link to my Patreon page. I do these live stream concerts every month. And if you go to my website and click on the Patreon link, you can sign up for that because I'd love to spend some more time with you. So thanks for watching. Thank you, Hope on Demand. Thank you, Food for the Hungry. And thank you for watching this evening. I know you could have spent your time doing anything. You chose to be here. That means the world to me. I want to end with one more instrumental, and I end every show with this. This is actually my arrangement of Amazing Grace. I always say that I'm only doing this because of God's grace, and so that's where I want to leave it tonight. So this is Amazing Grace. Thank you. thank you so much for watching tonight. Thank you, Hope on Demand. Thank you, Food for the Hungry. It has been a privilege to spend this time with you. I hope you stay safe and healthy, and I hope to see you in person. Once I get back to touring again, please come see me at a show. I'd love to see you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and God bless. See you later.